Hello, dear girl. Guys, today we're going to talk about something. I'm very excited. You guys know the Colossal has been in our lives for like the longest time ever. It was the Kajal first and all of us flipped out, and then it was, I think, the other eyeliner. And then there's this. So today we're going to be talking about the Colossal Bold Liner by Maybelline. This retails for about 249 rupees. Bold Liner claims that it lasts up to 24 hours. It's bold black. It's smudge proof. It's waterproof. We are on with the brand with this one, with a lively pop of yellow that is consistent with the first, the second, and the third launch. The trifecta of bumblebee amazingness. Why did I say that? Why do I have to say shit like that? So essentially, I purchased it because I bought it 4 days ago. The second I bought it, I posted this picture on Instagram and I asked you guys what you wanted to see, and most of you were like, everything. But I didn't really want to do it at one go because I find it's very confusing for a lot of people. So we're doing this. I didn't really have a lot of expectations because a lot of times when people say 24 hours, unless it's that lipstick like this one by Maybelline, it's not 24 hours. So, but I take their claims with like a pinch of salt, like 4, 5, a whole dabba of salt. The first time I used this eyeliner, I had no makeup on my face, was completely bare skin. Today I have a moisturizer and some setting powder, and then I just apply this eyeliner. This is what it looks like. Okay, I really like the packaging because it's so light and it's so small that if you are taking this to college or if you are taking this to office, there won't really be an issue because it's just easy for you to use. The one thing that I absolutely love is the wand, or the brush as you call it. I like to call it the wand because Harry Potter is life. I like how it sits on my hand. I like how I can maneuver it around. This wand is really good. It's a sort of a bristle wand. It is quite thick at the base, but it's extremely tapered and very, very fine at the end or the edge. This is very good with making really thin lines and then thickening them along the way. It also goes on extremely dark. Apart from that, the eyeliner dries very quickly, which is a great thing, and it dries into a matte formula. So it looks something like this when it's dried, as compared to something like a hyper glossy, which dries out glossy. So I really like the fact that this is very easy on your hand, very easy to apply. The wand is really good. It's so light. When you do have it on your eyes, you do not feel like you have an eyeliner on. I tried the Fenty eyeliner, and even that one, it kind of bleeded into the skin, which makes no sense. But this one does not do that. It dries very, very quickly, which is great. But we are just getting started. This is exactly the reason why I do not do first impressions, because they suck, okay? At least for me, I cannot understand about a product just by using it once. So I have to use even makeup products at least a week in order for me to see if it works or not. So this, the first time I applied it, I really thought this was going to be thebomb.com, but it wasn't. I'm not gonna say it because I'm anyways being so sassy right now. I'm just gonna include the clips of me using it for the first time, and then we're gonna go forward with that. Yeah. Hey guys, it's just been a couple of minutes since I've applied the eyeliner. It looks something like this. I actually quite like it. I also really like the brush of the eyeliner. I'm gonna try to give you guys some updates throughout the day, how exactly it has gone. I don't really have any makeup on my face today, so, and I'm sweating a lot because it's really disgusting weather here in Delhi. So let's see if the Colossal actually lasts or not. Okay, so something bad happened. I was in the washroom and I forgot that I have an eyeliner on, and I just kind of went like this. I thought that
my eyelash was stuck somewhere, so all I did was I just swiped my finger like that to put it in place, and then the whole eyeliner came off. It's about an hour after that. I have to go outside, so I reapplied the eyeliner here. It looks pretty much the same on this eye, which I did not rub at all on. And yeah, I think I'm gonna come back at towards like the night time and show you guys what exactly it looks like. It's almost been about 6 hours, and this is what it looks like in those 6 hours. I don't know if you guys can tell, but from both the winged areas, like right here and here, it's like spreading, but it's spreading like this. Oh yeah, you see that? This is what it's doing. Like when I go like this, it might look like it's fine, but when you raise your skin, you can see that it's particle by particle disintegrating. The same thing is here. Do you see? So it's doing that. I don't feel like this is holding up as well as I want to. Also, most of the inner corner eyeliner is pretty much gone. I don't know why. The other days I did use this with makeup on, I used this with foundation on, I used it with powder on, and it always gave the similar result. It does not last for 24 hours. It's not waterproof. If you do spill some water on you and you accidentally like go like this, it will just completely come off. It will not smudge, however, because it does not smudge. It does not, the viscosity, oh my god, science. The viscosity of this product is as such that when water hits it, it does not drip, or it does not make you look like this, but it just becomes like particles and just dissipates. It was literally like the eyeliner was moving away from my eyes. Like, this eyeliner had an existential crisis on my eyes, and it was like, nope, I'm gonna be eyebrow powder, you know. So yeah, so in my experience, this is a really good eyeliner in terms of packaging, in terms of the wand shape, in terms of the formula being easy to apply, and in terms of just like the packaging, it's very easy for you to carry around. But the claims of this being 24 hours does not apply to me. I do not think this is waterproof. I do not think this is smudge proof. Also, I don't think this is gonna work in Delhi heat, because this one sweats a lot. So, and especially I sweat right around here on these Pahari cheeks. This is an okay eyeliner, but for the claims that they made, personally for me, according to my experience with this product, it did not work for me. Please do not go for people who said that this is a good eyeliner. A lot of people don't sweat. A lot of people don't like test the product with water, and a lot of people don't have the same eyes as me, so every single person is going to have a different experience with the same product. So please don't say anything bad to people who have said that this is a good product. For me, it didn't work out. For somebody else, this might as well be somebody's favorite eyeliner. So for me, it didn't really work out. If you guys have tried this, please let me know in the comment section what exactly you thought about it, because I'm just so confused. Like, I was super like hyped up about this, and then it didn't work out, so kind of sucks. So would I recommend this to you? Hell no. I would suggest that you go for Lakme Shine Line. There's a lot of Lakme products that I dislike a lot. There's a lot of Lakme products that I absolutely love a lot. I have worked with Lakme in the past. I've also worked with Maybelline in the past. But the truth is, their Shine Line, okay, if you guys have tried the Maybelline Colossal Bold Liner, definitely let me know in the comment section. Definitely let me know what exactly you feel about it, what you thought about it, if you had a good or like a bad experience with it, because with me, the bumblebee magic did not happen with me. So if you guys have any other questions, definitely let me know those as well in the description box. And I'm gonna go now. I hope you guys have a great week. I'm gonna be back with another video next week, and that's about it. Bye. The packaging of it, was that fine? I love it. It's so cute and tiny and just
the cutest eyeliner. Actually, you know what? The Hyper, it kind of looks like the Hyper Gloss, Hyper, whatever that one was. And that's about it. Oh shit, follow me.